Hello guys, welcome to our new series in this channel. It is called the How to Create a Snake Game in Java. We will recreate one of the most famous 2D game that I know you are familiar with. So first of all, I want to show you the possible output of our game. Here, I'm gonna run this game. So as you can see, this is a very basic game. You need to press the enter to start the game and then just eat all the food which is a box colored gray and grow the snake. Then on the lower part we can see the score of our game and the current high score on the right. The movement can be controlled using the W for up, A for left, S for down and D for right. We can also use the arrow keys which is directly corresponds to up, down, left, right. If you became long enough and collided with your own body, you will die. And if you collided on the border, you will also die. So basically, this is a very simple game without any complicated physics and animation. So if you are new to Java, check my other playlist called Java Programming Tutorial Basic that covers most of the basics that we will discuss here. But I will explain each of the code that we're gonna write here for you to fully understand the basic mechanics of the game so that you can build your own base on this example. And I really encourage you if something does not make any sense to you, you can post your question in the comment section and I will answer it promptly. Okay, so let's go and first explain the context of what we're going to develop in the Java. So I created this spreadsheet to represent the snake world. So the horizontal, I entered numbers to represent the x-axis, and the vertical is the y-axis. So if we're going to draw the snake in this snake world, we need these coordinates to represent each of the body. So for example, our snake will be of size 4, so it will represent 4 points in our environment. So let's say this one is the head, so let's add some color. So let's say the head is red, and these two bodies will be blue, okay, and the tail will be yellow, okay, yellow or violet, but okay. So let's say this is a snake and the head is the red and it is located in the we can represent it like a coordinate. So let's say the x of this head is equals 11 and the y is equals to 12. Okay, then the body, the other half of the body, is located in the x, which is 10, but the same 12, which is y. Okay, the other half just 9 for the x and 12 for y, and the tail is, as you guess, is on the 8th position and the y is in the 12th. Okay, so now if we make the snake to move, means the head will be moved downwards, so this one will become the head now, which is red. This one will be the first half of the body. Okay. This one is the second half of the body, and this will become the tail, and this will be empty. Okay. Now all of those values will be adjusted. Okay, and the values will be adjusted also. So this one will be 12. This is the 11. This is 10. And this is 9. So these numbers are really important to in our game, because we need to monitor the movements of the snake, and we need to save each part of the snake, and it will follow the head whenever it will go. So if the head will go left side, it will go here first. So this will become our head, and this will become the other half of the body, and this will become the tail, and this will be empty. So no fill. Now the head will change its coordinate. It will be x12, but the y will be 11. The other half of the body becomes x12, y12. This one became x11, y12, and this become x10 and y12. So every time the snake moves, we need to adjust the X and Y for each of the parts of the snake. So for example, we have the food here, and let's mark it red. So the snake will need to move, or you're going to control the snake to move and eat the food there. So it will become something like this. Okay, so I am mimicking the animation that we're going to draw in the Java. So that is the main idea here. And if the snake eats the food, it will become longer. So this will now become 5 parts. So 1 head, 1 tail, and a 3-part body. Okay, so that's the main idea that we need to control in the movement of the snake. So let's continue the movement of the snake. So this one will be so each time the snake will move, so we need to, for the program to represent it accurately. So let's say it's about to eat the food. Okay. And then so when the head is on the overlap, overlap the food, so it now becomes 5. So this is the head now have a different coordinates. It now ends at x9 and y10. The second part of the body is x10, y10. Second half of the body becomes x11, y10. Then x12, y10. And then a new tail becomes x12, y11. So that is a simple movement, okay? And the snake eat the food and becomes longer now. So after the snake eats the food, the game will generate another food in a different location randomly, and so on and so forth. So that is basically the whole game here, and we're going to start the programming this game in the next video. Okay, see you guys. Thanks.